Good afternoon, everyone.
Good afternoon, Doctor.
Okay, thank you, Kaichuan. Wait, who's speaking? This is Jonathan, okay. So I'm going to share the link again for the attendance. Let's start our class, right? Now, today's class also, it will be maximum 1 hour only. Part of my mistake is I asked you to submit assignment 2 tomorrow, right? The due for assignment 2 is actually next Wednesday. Sorry about that. Because I don't think so. I'm going to teach best hydraulically or most hydraulically efficient section today, because I need some 1 hour or so to finish it. So let's just go slow, because chapter 2 supposedly we need week 2 up to week 4 to cover chapter 2. So this is only our week 3, right? So tomorrow we are going to look at most efficient section, most effective section, and then we'll be ahead lah 1 week. Alright, so next week we'll start chapter 3. We are going to finish chapter 2 tomorrow, alright? Now, so the due date for submission would be next Wednesday. I'm going to change it, alright, on Google Classroom. Another thing, I think you need to start working on your project already. You have all the instruction, all the necessary document already shared, and then you also have your own group member, right? Most probably you don't have to wait until last minute. In the meantime, right, I try to prepare a video to help you, to guide you with your project. It's easier. But in the of course, you need to start something first. For example, you can start writing your introduction, the purpose, the goal of your project. Take a look at the, drawings and stuff. All right. Because I think you have ample of time, right? Working or studying at home. Okay. Now let's begin our lesson for today. So let's look at our where we stop. All right. Last class. Let's look at our PowerPoint. Okay, I believe we actually stop at conveyance, and also we also have suction factor. We go through this already, right? Now, what is conveyance? Maybe I could have someone help me. Okay, could I have maybe... let's see who is here. Okay, let's ask Jonathan. Jonathan, you are there, right?
Yes, doctor.
Okay, what is conveyance, The formula for conveyance, let's consider Manning formula. What is the formula for conveyance?
K equal to 1 over n multiplied by a r to the power 2 over 3.
How about if we don't want to use 1 over n a r to the power of 2/3? That means we don't want to write our conveyance in terms of the function of depth, right? Because a and r contain depth, right? Is there any other equation that we can use to find K?
Any other equation you can use to find K?
using many formula. What is 1 over n ar to the power of 2/3 equals to? Let's look at what's the relationship with q and s naught half.
The section factor?
No. We're just looking at convenience now. Am I right? Okay, I could actually say k equals to q over s naught to the power of half. Also equals to 1 over n a r to the power of 2/3.
Yeah.
Okay, so actually, the other expression that I expected from you guys is k equals to q over s naught to the power of half, also equals to 1 over n ar to the power of 2/3. Am I right? It's the same, right? I just rewrite Manning formula, right? Okay, yes, Azmir, you got it. Okay, Jonathan, you okay?
Yes, okay, doctor.
Okay, so clear. So the same thing, okay, Chazy, I could rearrange it. You see, k is a convenience, the symbol for convenience, which I mentioned just now. The other expression that I could use to find k is also q over s naught to the power of half. Now let's look at the definition. Convenience is the carrying capacity of the channel, which is q, over longitudinal slope. It actually it shows k is equal to q over s naught to the power of half. Alright, it reflects. So just in case you forgot, if there is a question on what is convenience, you just look at your formula. It doesn't matter Chazy or Manning. Once you remember k is equal to q over s naught half, you actually can define it already, which is the carrying capacity. It doesn't matter if you want to write rate of flow over unit longitudinal slope, it's okay. Alright, I accept it. Alright, it's the same. Okay, so I'm just teaching you a way you can, remember the definition without memorizing it lah. Okay, I actually accept all, as long as you understand, you can express it in your own words, I will accept it as correct. Alright, I'm not the type who would expect you to write exactly 1-to-1, alright? Now, remember last class, right, we also have used or rearranged or rewritten Manning and Chazy in terms of function of that, where we said we want to put, since it involved question where we need to find depth of flow, we said we are going to, rearrange Manning and or Chazy equation in terms of where we put all the functions of depth on the left side and those the known values right on the right side, okay, on the right hand side. So basically this is equal, this is the same as Z, which is section factor. Now section factor, the symbol for section factor is uppercase Z, is different from the Z lowercase z that we use for the side slope for trapezoidal and triangular. Be careful of that, because sometimes actually most of the time students get confused when I ask what is section factor. They give me lowercase z, they say they define it as the side slope. Alright, it's different, uppercase z, alright, or capital Z is AR to the power of 2/3, which is a function of depth of flow. When you say section factor, you just try to remember, right, the meaning of it is when you rearrange AR to the power of 2/3 or AR to the power of half for Chazy, just to find normal depth, right, for certain question, right, that involve you to that need you to find why. Alright, why not? Alright. Okay, this is what we have learned last class, alright? Now, after going through your assignment 1, I found that some of you might get confused, you know, with the wetted, what is wetted parameter is about. Alright, so I'm just, this is just, you know, a refresher slide. Alright, let's go through slowly what is wetted parameter is about. Now let's look at the first compound channel. So we kind of have, you know, combination of two trapezoidal, the bottom and top. Alright, so let's say we are going to divide into two subsections, 1 and 2. Alright, now, oh, it's going too fast already. Okay, now, if I'm going to find my total wetted parameter, alright, for this section, the wetted parameter for this compound channel, for section 1, alright, this is my wetted parameter, the one in red color. And then I would add it to the wetted parameter for section 2, which is only this. Alright, I wouldn't be considering the dash purple line, because it's just a imaginary line for me to separate between section 1 and 2. It's not a boundary, it's not the channel's boundary, or by right it's not the wetted parameter for section 2, eh? Because there's no boundary, alright? There's no boundary at the dashed line, the purple dashed line there, alright? Now, let's look at section 2. This all this compound channel, I actually extract it from all your question. Now, the same for this compound channel also, I'm going to divide it into two subsections. So, I have a semicircular. I said semicircular because, you know, the dashed line cross exactly the middle or the center of the circle, which is denoted by the cross. Now, therefore, I have two subsection, 1 and 2. If I want to find the wetted parameter for subsection 1, this is my wetted parameter. You know, I could use half of theta d, all right, to find my I just use theta d. My theta would be, you know, 180 divided by 2, so it's 90 degree. All right, you know that, you know, half a circle, your 2 theta would be 180 degree, eh? Okay, now the wetted parameter for section 2, okay, remember the dashed line is only imaginary line. Okay, the boundary of the channel is the one shown as a yellow line. Alright, so that is the yellow and red line on your wetted parameter for this compound channel. Okay, the third and last compound channel. Okay, let's look at this. I'm going to divide into three. It doesn't matter if you want to divide in two subsections, it's fine too. It doesn't matter. The answer would be the same. Okay? So I have 1, 2, and 3. I have a segment of a circle. I have a rectangular section. And I also have a triangular or half triangular section. Alright? So, for the segment of the circle, that would be my wetted parameter. Of course, in this case, 2 theta should be less than 180, because your center of your circle is actually above the dashed line. Eh? It's not quite semi-circle. It's actually a segment only. Alright? So for subsection 2, what is the wetted parameter? The one I draw in yellow line. Meanwhile, for section 3, this is the one. Eh? Remember again, the dash line is only imaginary. I want to separate into three subsections. That's it. Alright, I hope you are okay lah. Alright, so far, do you have any question? Are you okay with this?
Okay, doctor.
Alright, great, Jonathan. Okay. The others you could respond to, eh? Pity Jonathan. Okay, no question. Okay. Let's go through. Okay. Let's look at one of the assignment, exercise 6. Okay, now we have gone through similar exercise. similar exercise where the question asks us to find normal debt. You know, in the first chapter, we already gone through what is normal debt is about, what is debt or flow. So basically, normal debt, in our syllabus, we could equate it to debt, all right? Debt, vertical debt, we said is the same as the debt of flow measured perpendicular to the bottom. And in this case, this normal debt is also equivalent to uniform debt of flow, which is y subscript 0 or y naught. Alright? Okay, let's look at exercise 6. We have a rectangular channel. The width is 5 meter. The longitudinal slope, that means the slope along the channel, is 1 to 2000. So S naught is 1 divided by 2000 lah. How, this is the way you get your slope. So it's equal to, you know, 5 times 10 to the power minus 4. Manning roughness coefficient is given as 0.017. Rate of flow is 6 Qsec. Alright. So question asks you to find normal depth. So okay, now here's the thing. There are so many steps, arrangement of steps, alright? You don't necessarily have to follow my step. For example, I straight away write, you know, my Manning roughness equation in terms of section factor already. I put there AR to the power of 2/3 equals to QN over S naught to the power of half. This is, I think I've told you that, you know, hydraulics is, you can score A+ as long as you do a lot of exercises. So once you have, you know, gone through few questions, similar question, you can straight away write AR to the power of 2/3 equals to QN over S naught to the power of half. Of course, this is for Manning equation. So for Chazy, okay, you would have AR to the power of half equals to Q over C to the power of half, S naught to the power of half. Therefore, alright, okay, I don't mind if you want to write, you know, your Manning equation first, then rearrange it, so you have more steps, right? You are just being careful, it's fine, okay? I make mistakes, right? Okay? So you might not want to rush, because if you make one mistake, a mistake at one certain step, okay, you know, the subsequent answers will be wrong. So just go slow, alright? So I have, for this rectangular section, area, flow area, is just B times Y, so I have 5Y. Weather parameter, B plus 2Y, I have 5 plus 2Y. Okay. I combine A and R because my R also have a over P, right? So A to the power of 3 over 3 times A to the power of 2 over 3, I have A to the power of 5 over 3. I hope you are following. If I'm too fast, just drop me a message saying go slow, right? Okay. Then substitute rate of flow, Manning coefficient, and slope. So you have and then you calculate, all right, the expression of section factor. So you would have AR to the power of 2/3 equals to 4.562. okay, remember last class I asked you few times, I asked you to go to try find out how you are going to use your calculator to solve expression like this. The one that you cannot have direct answer, you cannot solve it directly, where you have to, you know, try why not. By and your calculator, actually, when you write the expression of, you know, open bracket 5 times y, close the bracket to the power of 5 over 3, you write the whole expression equals to 4.562. You just press solve, you are going to get what is your y. you actually you still have time and to learn, because chapter 2, chapter 3, chapter 4, you need to know how to solve, you know, such an equation using your calculator. Further chapter, I think chapter 4, you need to solve quadratic equation where you are going to have two answers. Alright, when I say quadratic, that means you have two answers of y, which is y1 and y3. So you better equip yourself with the skill of using the calculator to solve such expression. You know, ask your friends, ask your senior, or learn it from YouTube. You should be able to do it. Alright. Now, last week we learned try and error. That means, you know, using the sub expression, we just, you know, solve it using calculator, or you could do try and error. But just in case, if the question, but I believe it will be very seldom question will ask you to solve such, you know, equation using graphical chart and using design chart and also graphical method. Now, what is graphical method? Just in case there's a question ask you, you know, don't just use calculator to solve it, but use a graph to solve such an equation. Okay, now I actually rewrite the same expression, AR to the power of 2/3 equals to 4.562 again. Okay, let's say we are going to solve this using graph. Okay, so I said I substitute y naught equals to 1, I get my AR to the power of 2/3 equals to 3.995. Not yet. So I add 1.2, 5.217, exceeding 4.562. So I try 1.5. Okay, a 7 point, of course I know if I increase it, my AR to the power of 2/3 or my suction factor will increase. Alright, so now I have 3 y naught with 3 answers for my suction factor. So I draw a graph. You know, it doesn't matter if your axis is, you know, it can be interchangeably. Maybe your y naught is like the x axis, your you know, your suction factor or AR to the power of 2/3 is on your y-axis. It doesn't matter. So let's say we have the graph there in our axis, because my y naught should cover up to 1.5 and my AR to the power of 2/3 should cover up to 7.184. Alright, so I have such a you know, scale already. So I draw the 3 points. Of course, if my y naught is 0, alright, the whole thing will be 0, right? Or okay. Now, so I have 4 points there. Okay, this is how we solve the question using graph. So my intention, we need to find what is y naught when AR to the power of 2/3 equals to 4.562. So what we are going to do is, we are going to find where is our 4.562 point, draw a straight line to intersect with our graph there, because don't forget, this is a graph where you try few y value and it will give you, you know, the respective section factor value. All right so once it intersect the graph, okay, draw a horizontal line to read what is y naught. So it will be approximately 1.1 meter. All right here's the thing, just now when we solve try and error, right, our solution is 1.094. Of course, when you ask me why doesn't this answer the same, of course you are reading from a graph, alright? The accuracy would not be that accurate, but if you round it up, it's still almost the same, 1.1 meter. Now this is the way graph, but again, common way to solve this type of question where you need to find you know, the uniform depth of flow is normally using try and error. Okay, now the third method or third way to find to solve for this you know, to get normal debt is you using design chart. If the question asks you to use a design chart, it's actually the chart will be given to you. Okay, you wouldn't, you know, you cannot draw this chart because normally this chart is from, you know, experimental. It could be theoretical, right? It's drawn from theoretical data. Now, here's the thing. Look at this chart. The x-axis is actually the value of AR to the power of 2/3 divided by B, which is a width. Look at, you have figures right in the inset, right? You have trapezoidal figure, you have a circular figure. You know, the diameter of the circular section D is represented by D0. The width of the bottom of the trapezoid section is represented by lowercase b. So now you know what is B and D0. So you have, you know, your x-axis is actually representing AR to the power of 2/3 divided by B to the power of 8 over 3. Or if you're using a circular channel, you have AR to the power of 2/3 divided by D to the power of 8 over 3. Your y-axis is y over b, that means y over your width, or y over d0. If you are using circular, then you are referring to y over d0, alright? Now, our question, alright, involve a rectangular channel again. Now, rectangular channel, which line should you look at, alright? Where z is equal to 0, am I right? I deleted the red line already. It's fine. Okay, now, you just look at this, just the line immediately below, you know, the circle graph, okay? Alright then. Now, the next step is, since our x-axis represents the value of AR to the power of 2/3 and you need to divide it by B to the power of 8 over 3, so you need to find the value. Look at the, I've already found the value, is given at the top right of the slide, right? So that value is 0.06241. So draw a line that intersects the line where z is equal to 0, which is for rectangular lah, alright? Because there's no slope, right, for rectangular. And then once it intersects, draw a horizontal line. You are going to get your y over b. Okay, this is your y over b. In order to find your y, your value, the one that you found, which is 0.22, okay, you need to times your b. Alright, so your b is 5. So you obtain y naught equals to 1.1 meter. So similarly, you have three ways to find it, right? Just now also you found, using graph method, you also found the depth to be 1.1 meter. So those are the three methods, alright? Again, normally you need to know your trial and error lah, alright? That is the simplest way and most accurate way to find your depth, alright? Now, so far, alright, we have learned three methods to find depth of flow. Okay, now activity 2.9 also involve, alright, similar question to find depth of flow but using trapezoidal channel. Okay, so given here Manning roughness coefficient, so I rewrite Manning roughness flow equation, Manning resistance flow equation, in terms of suction factor. Okay, alright, in terms of suction factor, so I need A and R, expression of A and R, and also Q and S naught, right? So it's given there, alright? So looking at this trapezoidal section, right, what is my A? My A is BY plus ZY squared. B is given as 5 meter, so I have 5y plus 1.5y squared. What is my z? Remember this z, the side slope z, is lowercase z, is different from your section factor capital uppercase z. So there is the horizontal scale, which is represented by the uppercase H. So Z is 1.5 lah. Eh? Alright, my S naught is 0.0035. Okay. Then weighted parameter, simple, straightforward. B plus 2y square root 1 plus z squared. So I have there 5 plus 2 square root 3.25y. Alright. So my hydraulic radius is such. Okay. Now this time, if you look at my slide, right, I didn't combine the A and R. Eh? I have such an expression. So it doesn't matter if you want to combine. If you are worried about, you know, having mistakes when you combine the power or combine the expression, you might want to do it, you know, slowly, step by step. So you have such. Alright, and then at the end, I combine it as well. Alright, okay. So I'm solving Qn over S0 to the power of half. I have 16.036. Okay, so I use calculator. I solve it, solve the expression. I found that my Y is equal to 1.82. Alright, now, okay. Now this is, you know, the table by try and error is just our traditional way, conventional way of doing try and error, because last time our calculator is not scientific. Alright, we need to calculate one by one. Alright, so it takes some time. So nowadays the calculator is more advanced. You can press the solve button and you can solve it. Alright, now I also prepare an answer for the graph. Okay, you may go through it. Okay, and then the design chart. For this, you know, I choose the graph where z is equal to 1.5. Eh? Even the graph, the figure of the trapezoidal shows where z is. Eh? So, you know, this is why I asked you to use the formula that involves z. You could actually find your trapezoidal flow area using the, you know, without using z. Alright, but of course we need y and also, you know, zy value. Alright, so we can solve it too. But it's I prefer you to use the formula given in the table, you know, all those A, P, T, R, D in the table, right? For the basic sections. Even the circular one, right, I would prefer you to use those formula. For example, flow area is equal to d squared over 8, and then you have in bracket 2 theta minus sine 2 theta, right? It's easier. Okay. Now this is using graphical method. Okay. So you see, I have b to the power of 8 over 3, right? This is to find the value at the x-axis for the design chart. Okay, in the setting, so I have my y naught. Now this chart here, right, is this for our syllabus. Sometimes if you are practicing, when you have graduated, you'll be practicing and practicing engineering works, right? They would be, you know, standard or manual where you have to follow. Sometimes, you know, there will be certain graph provided in the manual or standard such as this. Alright, so you can find your you know, use design chart given. Alright, so don't be too, you know, in our class we try to simplify things, but in reality sometimes there are so much, you know, so vast information that you have to you have to utilize all of them. Now, activity 2.10, alright, 2.10, is also similar question. So I'm not going to go through it because I already provide you the solution. All you have to do is go through it. When I say go through it, without looking at the solution, you try it yourself and check your answer against the solution. Who knows, you might text me saying, hey, there's something wrong. We said there's something wrong with the solution. Alright, like your friends, a few of your friends have done it, right? You have, then I'll correct it. Alright, okay. Because I also make mistakes, right? Okay, now same thing here. I solve it using try and error, so I have my B. Okay. Here's the thing. In this activity 2.10, the question actually not just asking you to find depth of flow. The depth of flow is given, yes, as 2.5 meter. The question asks you to find width, the bottom width of the trapezoidal section. Similarly, you can't get the answer directly. It's implicit, it's not explicit. So you have to do try and error as well. Okay. Therefore, this question, you also have to do try and error, and you'll get what is the bottom width of. Alright, which is equal to 16.33. Okay. This one normal depth. I think we have gone through this. Okay. So you just again, I would like you to try all the exercise out. So it's easier for you to write your tasks as well as your exam. I actually wanted to say this. You know, for example, I have this activity 2.11, right? In your test and your final exam, right? This is only a quarter of your one question. Because normally one question you would have to answer, you know, one A, one B, one C, one D. This is only, for example, one A. Alright? There are three quarter yet you have to answer. So you really have to go fast. And normally, one full question, alright, which contain a few sub questions, you have on average only 30 minutes to answer it, to solve it. So you have to go, it's just that for me, you won't have time to dwell on any question basically. You will be wasting your time, alright? Once you have the question, you should straight away do it. You would have once you have done it, solve it, you would have few minutes, 5 to 10 minutes to check, go through it and check, alright? Alright, that's why if you try a few times, you'll be very fast really. Now, activity 2.12, same thing, you have to find your depth of flow. Now, for activity 2.12, it involves a circular section. Alright, you know that in this case, alright, the unknown that you are going to find is theta. Alright, but the question asks you to find why not, but friendly speaking, alright, those expressions involved in solving this question here involves theta, the unknown theta. So once you have solved for theta, you can actually find your y, okay? Because once you have find your theta, you can find the vertical distance from the center of your circle to the free surface or the surface of the flow. Once you have that value, because of course you are using your trigger function, trigonometric function, then you have your r minus that value, you'll get your y. I hope you understand. That's why I want you to try it, and if you have problem, let's discuss it. You can discuss it with me, Okay. Of course, for this case, right, I'm going to give you a drawing, right? How you are going to find your why not later, because it's not very clear from this slide here. Okay, this is using the design chart as well, but you can solve it using try and error. Okay, so there are many ways. I have the circular there. Okay, now let's look at exercise 7. Okay, now previously, okay, in previous question, is we look at question that involve basic sections. We have trapezoidal, we have circular, segment of a circle, we have rectangular or even triangular. For triangular section, you don't need to solve it using try and error. For triangular section, you can solve it directly. Okay, now for this exercise 7 here, this is a compound section where at the bottom you have triangular section, and the top it is actually a rectangular section. So you were asked to find depth of flow. Okay, so let's see what are the knowns value. The angle given, alright, that makes the side of the triangular section mixed with the horizontal line is 45 degree. So therefore, what is the distance of your horizontal and the length of your horizontal and vertical line or vertical side? It should be 2.25 and 2.25 meter, because 45 degree, that means your z is equal to 1, 1 to 1. How do you find 2.25? Is actually this horizontal scale, right? Oh, sorry, horizontal dimension is half of your 4.5 meter, right? Because if you look at the top there, it's given as four. The width of the section is 4.5, so half of it is 2.25, alright? So similarly, your vertical would be 2.25 because your horizontal and vertical scale is 1 to 1, since the angle is 45 degree. Okay, tangent 45 is 1. Alright, therefore, okay, this is the solution for exercise 7. I'll be sharing this with you through WhatsApp later. Okay, now this one I also I didn't involve too much steps, but for you I would prefer you to go slowly lah. All right, you have more steps. All right, than me. Here is the thing. If you look at it, in the question, the question already give you Q equals to 23 meter cube per second. I actually need to find Y naught. But in this case, for compound section, I need to check whether the 23 meter cube per second exceed the section, exceed subsection 1. So I said I want to find, Q1 first. I want to check. Okay, I said I want to check for Q1. So I said, because you need to know your Y naught is actually Y1 plus Y2. If your Y naught is less than Y1, you are actually looking at Y1 only. There's no point, adding up with the section of 2. Alright, adding up with Y2. So I said I want to check first what is my Q1. Alright, so straight away I use the Manning, because Manning coefficient is given. I said I want to find Q1, so straight away I substitute all the known value for section 1. So I have Q1 equals to 0.4346. I said, 0.4346 is actually less than 23 Qsec. Alright, so I said the flow should be beyond the triangular section. So my Y naught is actually the addition of Y1 and Y2. So now, after I check my Q1, Alright, and I know what is my the section that would be involved, because I don't know whether my y naught is just up to y1 or it is beyond y1. Alright, now I know that y naught actually is the addition of y1 and y2. So straight away I could use y1 as 2.25 meter already, because I know my the only changing value would be y2, eh? So my goal here is to find what is y2. Because when I find what my y2, my y naught is equal to y1 plus y2. y1 will be 2.25 lah. So the flow area for the compound channel would be z1 y1 squared, because I separate into two subsection, right? Plus b2 y2. Okay? So I have there my flow area of the compound section is 5.063 plus 4.5 y2. My vector parameter is 6.364 plus 2 y2. Okay, now if you look at my a and p, right, I already substitute y1, eh? Because I know y1 is 2.25 meter already. The only unknown is y2, so therefore, you know, rewriting my section factor expression, I can find y2. Okay, but my q is now 23 lah. Okay, because that is the rate of flow where I want to determine what is my y naught. Eh? So using try and error, I found that y naught is equal to 0.7601. Therefore, my y naught, this one y2, eh? Therefore my y naught is y1 plus y2. It is therefore 3.01. Now if you are not confident with this answer, you can always go and check it. That means you can substitute your y naught again. Well, of course you need to separate your y naught to y1 and y2 lah. Okay, and you'll get, you know, your q equals to 23 meter cube over second. Right, so that is how you check. But of course, I don't think so you have much time lah to check, eh? Okay, but for class, yes, you have, but not during your test as well as your final exam, eh? Okay, you can always, you know, check backward engineering lah, basically. Okay, so this one I'm going to share this slide. I have another like 10 minutes, right? So I'm just going to have one to two slides to go through before we end our class today, and we'll continue tomorrow for the most hydraulically efficient section. Eh? That one, it's okay, I'll go through this first because I need you to do something as well. you have 1 hour, right, of our class. We can go through all the exercise, the one for today, as well as prepare a bit for tomorrow. Now, simplification for very wide rectangular channel. Okay, when it's very wide, of course the B is very big, right? Now, how big it is for it to be categorized as very wide is when your depth is so small that when you divide it by B, it's actually less than 0.02. It's about 50 times lah, alright? Okay, alright. 50 times smaller. Now for wide channel, it's actually very wide channel, eh? The term very is there. Y over B is small, therefore R is the R, eh? Hydroid radius is almost equivalent to Y. This is a simplification for cases where you know, the width of a channel is 50 times more than depth of flow. Okay, why? Okay, why is R equals to Y? You see, R, the hydroid radius, is equal to A over P. Let's assume, now, not just assume, this is for the case of rectangular channel only, rectangular channel. Now, let's see, When rectangular channel R is equal to A over P, which is B Y over B plus 2Y. If your Y is small, of course, B times Y for the flow area, A is affected by Y. If small, that means your A is small as well. You have B times Y, right? But for your hydraulic, for your vector parameter, B plus 2Y. If Y is a small number, your P is almost equivalent to B. So remember, your A is B, Y divided by B, therefore you have your R almost equivalent to Y. I'll give you some additional notes later, okay? Because I don't have my you know, drawing board here. It's hard for me to write, but I'm trying to explain as the best lah that I could, okay? So that's why your R is almost equal to Y, eh? Okay, I'll give you some additional notes later. Now, this is simplification for very wide channel. Of course, the criteria is when your B is 50 times larger than your depth, at least 50 times, it could be more, where you can say you can simplify your R equals to Y. There's another parameter that you are learning today is discharge over unit width, which is the lower case of Q, okay? Which is upper case of Q, which is the rate of flow, Q divided by B. So you have discharge over unit width, okay? Now, unit of Q, of course, is meter cube over second, that is your Q, right? Divided by B, which is your meter. Alright, this is now both of these is for rectangular channel only, eh? Because for triangular you don't have B, right? And then for your you know, your trapezoidal as well, okay? You it's actually your bottom width only, right? It's not the width of a channel itself. Or you see, eh? Q for rectangular channel, Q, the uppercase Q is also equal to A times V, which is your A is BY times V. Divided by a B, you will be left with YV only. Okay, I could rewrite this later, give it to you. So you have that discharge per unit width. So both of these simplifications is only for rectangular sections. Okay, now, this activity 2.13 as well as activity 2. Exercise 8 is actually for which actually involve very wide channel. The keyword is very. Alright, sometimes students confuse if I say a question, I say is the channel is 2 meter wide. They get confused. They just, you know, write there R equals to Y. It's different. This is very wide. Where you have the width of a channel is as much as at least 50 times larger than the depth of flow, right? Now, you look at the Manning equation that I use. I simplify it, okay? Q equals to YV is the one that we found just now, right? So what is V? It's 1 over N, R to the power of 2/3, S to the power of half. So I have there, you know, R, since R is equal to Y, the simplification for very wide channel is R equals to Y. So I combine my Y, I have that. See, I can solve it straightforward. I don't need to do trial and error, okay? Because this is a simplification that we made, okay? We assume Y to be very small, so it's negligible in the vector parameter. Now for exercise 8, I want you to try it. I'm not giving you the solution today. Alright, I'm giving you a solution tomorrow, so I want you to try this. We'll look at our answer tomorrow. Again, I would extend your assignment to next Wednesday instead of this week. I totally forgot that, you know, it's supposed to be next week where you have to submit it. Okay, it's already almost 3. we'll end our class today because as I told you, this topic 2.5 is not easy. I have to go through I have to have at least 1 hour to go through this. But for tomorrow class, where we want to go into this topic, and I want you to get yourself well versed with your differentiation. Okay? Remember what is differentiation is about, okay? Because we will be it will involve differentiation. For example, you want to differentiate P with respect of Y. So what will be the expression dp dy is equal to what? You have 2 lah, basically, things like that. Now of course you would rewrite this. You want to take into account of A and P, right? Okay, so your B you would have substitute with A over Y, so you will have that. So make sure you remember your differentiation for tomorrow class. So go through some of the simple differentiation that involves power, and things like that. Okay? So you may go through all this. I think I'll explain this tomorrow. Okay. Let's end our class up to let's end our class up to this simplification for very wide channel as well as discharge over unit width. Okay. Alright then. Do you guys have any question?
No, doctor.
No. Are you guys tired from the class? I believe so. Am I right?
I'm not tired, doctor.
Not tired, okay. good to know. Okay, now. I hope you will go through all the exercises. It's actually very simple. Hydraulics is a very simple subject. You easily can score the subject. I hope you will go through some of your, just go back to your. I think we learned differentiation right in our secondary school, right? Secondary studies. So let's go back and look at it. And then just another thing. When you want to submit your assignment, right? Next time, right? I would prefer you to write your name on your answer paper. Just because I want to recognize who's, because I actually mark it manually. I print out all your assignment and mark it manually, so it's easy for me. Alright. Another thing is, when you want to scan, I would prefer it to be PDF, because in your final exam later, not just for my course, for all the other courses as well, I would think all the instructor would prefer PDF version. You might want to start it, because I still accept if you want to give me a PNG file or JPEG or Word file, it doesn't matter, but try to find a way, because I think by the time you have your final, mostly, okay, you need to submit it in PDF form. And then when you do submission, right, make sure the one that you provide is clear. Your writing is clear. You can clearly capture your your answer, because not your class actually. When I marked final exam last semester, right, there are a couple of students where I really need to go through their soft copy and enlarge it as much as as clearly as possible, because it's just too vague. So I hope you can help me. Alright, and of course if you write it very clear, it's easy for me to mark, and I make less mistake lah. Okay. You have your written assignment, your graded assignment ready. If I make any mistakes, for example, if I accidentally Alright, deducted some marks, let me know. Okay, I'll always, you know, be open to admit my mistake lah, basically. Alright, yeah, it's already 3:01. I'll see you tomorrow, okay? At 2, at the same time. Alright, take care.
Thank you, Doctor.
Thank you.
Thank you, Doctor.
Thank you, Doctor.
Thank you.
Thank you, Doctor.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you, Doctor.
All right.